is going on, everybody, man? King Reek on here, dude. I'm still on the Stampede high, bro. The entire morning, I've just been thinking back to that greatness. I won't say anything for anybody who hasn't watched it, but it was amazing, man. It was amazing, yo. But, man, what a wonderful last 24 hours it's been, man. But here we are, and a new chapter is ahead of us, man. You know, I was asked, you know, Recon, how do you want to spend your birthday? Like, what do you want to do? And I was like, brother, just like every single week, there's nothing I would rather be doing than reading the latest installment in the best-selling manga in history. And today is no different. Baby, it's nearly the second best-selling comic of all time. We're talking about the one, the only dog. Super, super excited for this week with the Odin flashback on the horizon, man. Let's get right into it because I can't wait to see not only what it looks like, but to see what is going to be going down. Yo, look at the name of the chapter. The name of the chapter is called Kozuki Odin Takes the Stage. What a wonderful chapter title for Wano, because we know how Wano has the Kabuki act play structure. To have Odin taking the stage and then in a title indicates to us that this is going to be a pretty lengthy flashback, because now it's Odin's time to shine. It's Odin's performance. Let's go, man. I'm no longer being trolled. I'm no longer getting baited. The flashback is here, dog. This has been the flashback that I have been so looking forward to, man, ever since I would honestly say since Zoe. But the more that we've been alluding to it, like, I'm ready now, man. Chapter 960, Kozuki Odin takes the stage, and here we get to see the members right here. Look at Capone. Look at Capone, dog. As they're sitting here, you see a Lucy statue right here from Dressrosa, with Chiffon right here, and Lola dressing up, and attempting to go, they're searching for Lola. The sweet mother of Flagnards, man. Capone has this massive poster in hand, like, yeah, man, we're not being conspicuous at all, right? No, let's get right into it. This area is known for its grand flourishing forest. And we get to see the flower capital. Man, I'm already sweating, dog. That's how you know the Odin flashback is about to be legendary, when we're sweating and the chapter hasn't even started yet. The chapter has not even started yet, man. This area is known for its grand flourishing forest. And we get this wonderful page, or a panel rather, of the floating sakura blossom. See the massive mountain in the back, which has always reminisced Mount Fuji. You have the flower capital in the middle, and then you see like the rest of it. I always love whenever Oda gives us panels like these, really giving us a sense of scale of how everything looks, but especially in how beautiful an area like Wano looks. Like, I truly do appreciate us starting off the Odin flashback with the scenery and how it was 41 years ago. Which, by the way, if y'all weren't If y'all don't know about the corrections that Oda and his staff made last week, specifically Oda's editors tweeted, I believe it was on Monday after the chapter came out in Japan, that they made a slight correction to the year. It wasn't 39 years ago, but rather 41 years ago. Now, what's interesting about this entire thing is that had the flashback taken place 39 years ago, it would have taken place 1 year before the God Valley flashback. Now it's taking place 3 years before the God Valley flashback. So I just wonder why it is specifically that Oda wanted it to be 41 years ago and not 39. Why did they have to make that connection? What was it in Oda's notes that made him say, Flagnards, I've got to make this correction? So I'm really, really interested in seeing where that leads to, because what that tells me, and I already know this is going to happen, that we're going to have multiple time skips in that flashback, but how many time skips are we going to get in this flashback? And just how many things are we going to see in this flashback? Like, whenever I saw that correction, I was like, oh man, Oda's being particular. He really wants the information to be accurate, because we know how he is when it comes to attention to detail. So, really, really exciting stuff right there when it comes to what this flashback is going to have in store for us. And here we have a following panel. The vegetation thrives. I can't be the only one that now, every time I see a butterfly in anything, this doesn't have to be in One Piece either. Every time I see a butterfly in a movie, in a cartoon, in a comic, I always think of Instant Messenger-sama, dog. I always think of that panel in chapter 908 when Instant Messenger-sama has a butterfly on their finger, and it just goes off and flying. It's like, well, that's Instant Messenger-sama, you know what I'm saying? Due to the nearby clear rivers and the sparkling sea, And then we have Jing Freaks and the rest of them fishing right here. This is a tale from the past. You see them catching a fish? I caught one. Right here you see Bambi, a tale about when Wano was brimming with life. And you can tell how much things have changed since then, you know, what the pollution has done to the area ever since Kaido and Orochi took over. Which is insane, man, because Wano already, I mean, Wano looks beautiful today. Like, where we stand right now in the present of what is currently going down before we go into Onigashima, Wano still looks extremely beautiful. Even with that barren wasteland and the little small places that have been polluted to high flagnards, I still feel like at the end of the day, it's still a very beautiful looking country. But just imagine how it must have been back then. That's what Oda's trying to present to us here. Like, it was just look at how amazing and the atmosphere and the scenery was before Kaido and Orochi took over. Who is that? I was like, yo, hold on, Skip. I'm telling the truth. I swear I saw my own two eyes. The mountain was moving. The mountain moved? Indeed, we fled from it and ended up here. It was even growling. I had that one soundtrack playing from whenever I'm the din 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 from the flashback. I believe they used it whenever Tama and Luffy were cooking up rice in, I think it was episode 894 with the Ace flashback. I think it was in that episode when we first heard that soundtrack. I love that soundtrack. But right here with this really nice traditional Japanese looking home, even the flags are on the side. Yeah, this is a really, really nice looking panel. Yo, who is this though, dog? Perhaps you encountered a mountain god. Mountain Pass Tea House poster girl Surojo. Surojo. Or no, Surujo. I saw that U for an O. Surujo. Suru! Oh, Suru, bro! Nah, that... Kinemon? Does that even equate? Nah, bro. Osuru doesn't look that old. Is Suru really in her 60s right now, present time? Maybe Surujo is like a mother. But anyways, she's looking good. The three of you are quite chipper considering the circumstances. Foo, foo, foo. You got the Doflamingo laugh. Foo, foo, foo. Nothing gets past you. Oh, Suru. No way. It is Suru. No way. It is Suru. So if it's Suru, I'm trying to calculate this in my mind, dog. You feel me? Like, so how old is? I don't think it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at this point. Suru in her prime. Look at A1. Can we keep a secret? Can you keep a secret for us? The truth is, we were finally able to capture an elusive creature. It took us a whole year. Take a look at it. Wow, what a beautiful boar. Its skin is snow white. Look at that poor bastard. I feel like they're about to cook it. If we take this little guy to the capital, we can trade him in for one whole piece of white gold. A piece of white gold? You could buy a whole giant mansion with that kind of money. A giant mansion? Well, I guess so. If it's a piece of gold. I don't know if white gold is any different from regular gold. But I'm going to assume, like a video game, right? You have like this special type of currency that really, whenever you sell it, it gives you a whole bunch of gil or whole bunch of money. And so I suppose in that way, I can see that for sure. Yeah, but I feel sorry for that boar, doc. That boar is about to get cooked, son. Boss Kurokama has been saying this for years, that he wants a rare white boar to display outside his store. He put a bounty on it, but nobody's been able to capture it until now. That would be quite distasteful. White boars are considered heralds of the gods. Da ha ha ha! Cute story and all, but this is just an exotic animal. Hang on just a moment. And then here we see... What's going on? She pulls on somebody's neck. Did you steal money from my wallet again? Kinemon? No! Bro, my boy Kinemon was out here being a bandit. The man was a phantom thief, like he was playing Persona 5, dog. Hold on, coach. Yo, you gotta play the music. You gotta play the music every time I see Kinemon from now on, you gotta play it. Yo, Kinemon was a phantom thief, dog. That's crazy. So Kinemon also was, I'm going to assume, changed by the ways of Odin, Which I guess is pretty much obvious, but I want to see how much Sudo had an influence in that too. So Sudo, and so Kinemono Sudo's relationship before they got married was that he used to steal from her. That actually sounds hilarious. That's some great teacher Onizuka stuff. Did you steal one from Wally and Kinemono? Ow, 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 ow. Stop it, Sudo-jo. Think of our childhood friendship. Also, they were even friends as children. My big bros have been having money issues. Your big bros? I bet they gambled their money away. How many times have I loaned you money now? If you ever touch my money again, I'll rip out your organs and sell them to reclaim your debt. Hey, Sudo dog. Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta do what you gotta do. Yo, Kenny won't choke though, man. He's sweating. If you cannot afford to pay me back, then I will strip you of all of your belongings as payment. Thanks for the meal, Sudo. The money's on the table. And they just spread like, dog, we're not dealing with this nonsense. I'm pretty sure they've seen the same scene like billions of times. Oh man, that was awesome. That's crazy though that this man Kinemon was a thief, dog. Dan, dan, dan. You bastard, I remember you from earlier. Yo, a Yakuza thug from the capital, Kinemon. Bro, look at my boy, dog. My man's got the sumo kin thing going around the waist. And he's got the sword in hand, yo. He's got the rope hanging onto the hilt. Hey, Kinemon was a beast. I mean, he still is. Foxfire Kinemon, my man goes ham. Wahaha! You should be more careful when you talk in public. Of course, I would overhear you. This boar is worth one piece of white gold, right? My luck has finally turned around. I have hit the jackpot. Once I hand this over to Boss Kurokama, I will be a... Yo, this man... No, these individuals on the boar, bro. Like, I feel sorry for that thing. Look at him. Oink, oink. They're just salivating at this thing. Hand over your clothes and your money, too. I'm regarding Lord Odin. Odin. He really does lack the aptitude for sailing. Today was his 38th attempt to legally leave the country. The fact that he's still alive is surprising. 38th attempt? So what that tells me is that Odin continuously failed and failed and failed and failed and failed and failed. And he just could not leave the country. But that just shows his resilience. That by itself makes me really like his character because he does not give up. Yo, no matter how many times he takes L's, he is going to get it done because he's going to get it done, by God, man. He really has lived quite the eventful life. The Shogun of Wano, Kozuki Sukiyaki, Odin's pops. My man has a beard of legend. Bro, this man has the Waluigi Wario stash coming out from the sides, creating a W. And on the bottom, he has the Fire Lord Ozai from Avatar. Like, Fire Emblem hair... on his beard. Beard style. Yo, I would love a beard style like that, man. Can you imagine that? Having a beard style that looks like a... the fire? Literal fire? Yo, that looks mad fresh. My boy was looking... Hey, what? And then on his hair, dog, my man's got the three, like, 3 points going right up, and then the back is got the ponytail. Yo, my guy looks fresh. He really has lived quite the eventful life. Even as a baby, when he was less than a year old, he managed to fling his wet nurse across the... Fling his wet nurse? Watch out, Odin! By age 2, he was able to catch 2 rabbits with his bare hands. Is this man Jing Freaks, or what is he, dog? By age 4, he was able to throw a large boulder at a bear, crushing it to death. Odin sounds like Takamura to me. By age 6, he was roaming the red light district, wasting royal funds on his... So what you're telling me is that by age 6, this man Odin was Jing Freaks, Takamura, and Gintoki? Is that what you're telling me here, Skip? Oh, I mean, Odin's a goat. He's a goat. By age 8, he was getting drunk and starting fights with gamblers. And by age 9, even the Yakuza blacklisted him and banned him from entering their casino. Bro, Odin was out here living, dog. He was living the good life. He retaliated by setting their casino. He retaliated by setting their casino on fire. My man said, if I ain't getting it, no one get it. That's Gort. And Bradley started a war with him. It all culminated when he was captured at age 10, after he nearly killed someone. He was sentenced to hard labor in the stone quarry, where he showed off more of his unique talents. He climbed the ranks of the quarry until he was running the place. He truly is a member of the Kozuki family. Dude, I want to see him, dog! Enough hearing about him, I just want to see my guy! Odin, bro, yo, but that is amazing! All stuff that this man was able to accomplish by age 10. This man is insane, bro. Yo, I thought Kiryu from Yakuza and Majima had some insane upbringings. But yo, Odin might have just topped it what I just read, dog. Odin's out of this world. But after that, his attitude changed significantly. When he was 14 years old, the capital was experiencing a prolonged drought. The wells had dried up and countless people were suffering. So he diverted a river straight into the capital. But that only led to the capital getting flooded, so his capture was ordered. However, Lord Odin just followed that water route and attempted to escape out to sea. But in the end, that voyage was short-lived. Then at age 15, when he was in hiding, he got a job at a temple deep in the mountains. Every night he would kidnap women from the capital, eventually formed a harem. A harem? Dog, what? Odin, dog. The work of the devil. Even though the girls technically chose to stay of their own free will. Amen. They, you know, that's Odin, you feel me? Their loved ones were enraged. Their parents, spouses, and even powerful samurai attempted to rescue them. But Lord Odin stood his ground and eagerly took them on. My guy was out here being a classic Shonen Jump villain, dude. Capturing certain enemies and making them go on a rescue arc. This is what this man was. Odin was doing at age 15. My man Odin at age 15 was on some Shinra HQ Soul Society Enies Lobby Sasuke Retrieval Arc stuff. Causing people to go out and retrieve. And retrieve individuals. What a sicko. That event came to be known as the Harem Revolt. Dog. Is that my boy, bro? Is that yo? Even the Yogoro family got dragged into the fray after failing to prevent the fighting. Yogoro the flower. Lord Odin's victims number in the... That is quite enough. Of course, Lord Odin is 18 now. And he still causes trouble on a daily basis. You do not say another word. Just deliver this to Odin for me. No, the disowned thing. I believe that was the same thing that was stated in chapter 920. Whenever they were looking back to the flashback, whenever they were saying that Odin was disowned by his father. And I think that's whenever he got kicked over to Kui, right? If I'm not mistaken. This is the day you finally get caught. He went that way, captured Kinemon. Oh, hold on a second. I was just trying to cash in a bounty. Stop lying, you swindler. I'm not lying, just let me go to Kurokama's family's mansion. Kinemon, oh? Look at Hyo! My man looks so fresh! Straight up carrying that classic Yakuza tattoos. He's even got the pipe, dog. He's got the pipe, the jacket. His hair is out here, look like it's firebending on its own. Yogoro the flower. That kid stole our money. Catch him and flay him alive, is what I would normally say, but in a one-on-one fight, none of you would stand a chance. You must be joking, we'll bring him in right now. The chivalrous knight of the flower capital. Yogoro the flower, dog. My man's was looking fresh. I mean, if he looks fresh as an old man, my boy was definitely looking fresh in his prime. 41 years ago. You bought the wrong pot. The bigger ones are worth 60 pieces of silver, though. Yeah, but I can trade this pot back in for 30 pieces of silver, right? Sure, no problem with that. So if you add the extra 30 pieces of silver I spent when I bought this pot to the value of trading it in now, it should be worth 60 pieces of silver, so I should be able to get a big one. I suppose you're right. Here you go. Please come again. Hee-hee. An orphan from the capital, Denjiro. Denjiro! Alright, hey, we're starting to meet him. We're starting to meet the crew. Hey, the brat got a discount just like that? Why does this man kind of like Scopper, yo? Kind of like Scopper Gaban. The brat got a discount just like that? What a gullible store owner. Hey, Denjiro! Uh-huh. How did I end up with only 30 pieces of silver? The flower capital, crematorium, Sir Samurai, please do something about him. Grandpa Katsuzo. Hey, stop crying. I know this is odd for a funeral, but regardless, what is the matter? After cremation, we were going to collect the ashes, but then we'll just look over there. He is using the fire that burnt my father's body to boil some Odin. Boiling Odin? No! We finally, after all the months, after all the years of seeing this man's silhouette, after seeing his silhouette, we finally get to see what Odin looks like. And we see that on top of his head, and as we've been seeing the silhouettes, he has like this mushroom type of thing on top of his head. But yo, he actually looks mad fresh, man. He looks buff, too, dog. 18-year-old Odin. Lord Odin! This is really... Yo, this man is eating food while it's being grilled. He's grilling the food and eating it at the same time, dog. This stuff, huff, 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 huff. I don't understand what you are saying, but get off of my father. is an insult to his memory. Huff, huff.
Yo, bro.
Oh, Daniel, this man even has sake glued right there, dog. Talking about some... I mean, my man is eating... He's eating... Well, listen to me, dog. I don't think y'all understand what I'm saying. This man is eating food while it's being cooked. Do you know how goat you have to be to eat food while it's being cooked and not think about the consequences of that? Yo, Odin. This dude, I'm so happy we actually got to see his face though, man. I was wondering, I was like, when is Oda actually going to take him out of the silhouette and actually show him to us?
And here he is.
He looks fresh, man. I really like his design. Here we... Is this man... Bro, this man took it from the thing. His hand is burning. Bro, his hand is burning. He took the pot directly from the thing. With no glove, with no nothing. He took the pot and just started like guggling the whole thing like he shanks. Like he shanks and Whitebeard whenever they were drinking the sake with a massive cup. But that thing was cold. This thing is burning his hand.
See ya. The next time we drink together, Katsuzo, it'll be in the afterlife. Now then.
Bro, just look at that design, dog!
My condolences to the family. My apologies, he is not one for detailed explanations. Is that how it is? What is it with that guy? He's so cool. That means trouble. Hide your wives and daughters.
Hide your wives and daughters.
So this is a charming Odin from the rumors. And you get to see a skull clang, and then right next to it, you see that gourd. Did you guys come to capture me? Yes, well, I did end up being bribed, but you should not talk about such things out loud, you idiot. Anyways, what is going on here? No one is avoiding me like they usually do. The fire bell has been ringing nonstop, but there seems to be no fire nearby. Hey, is it a big fire? It is bigger than a mere fire. And Odin looks up.
Bro, with the way that Odin's hair looks from the side, it kind of looks like he has one of those classic pompadour haircuts. It makes him look even more fresh. Yo, my guy even got the sideburns coming down, too.
Yo, how could you not know about this, Kinemon? You should never have brought that with you. Oh, you mean the white boar?
I feel sorry for that boar, dog. I mean, it's just been waiting to die.
Boss Kurokama probably wanted to use it to crush the Hyogoro family. What do you mean, Danjiro? Like I said earlier, wherever that little boar goes, that its parent is not far behind. According to the ancient texts, a full-grown white boar is the size of a mountain. When we refer to them as mountain gods, it is said that hundreds of years ago, a whole region was annihilated in a single night.
That is not said for just nothing, dog. That is void sentry information right there. Hundreds of years ago, a whole region was annihilated in a single night. I thought that it was just a fairy tale, but what if this white boar is here?
Then that means... Clang, clang. A mountain god! A real one! We're going to be eaten alive. There are already many victims. Evacuate the capital. Oink, oink. And then you see this big...
You know that thing? Bro, like, what is it with this boar, dog?
I was right. It really showed up. Oh, crap. Will I be responsible for the destruction of this capital?
That is an interesting story to overhear. I may not know you two, but...
Kozuki Odin?
I want you to give me that boar.
And then you have Odin Ray smiling, dog.
Where's that boar even coming? I see it. I think I see it all the way in the back. Right back there. So you see the fire. And then right in the middle of that entire thing is this massive boar. Which apparently in the past was also... apparently responsible for annihilating a whole region in a single night. Now, what I'm curious, though, about this boar... is what its importance is going to be to this entire flashback. And like, why a boar? Like that's fascinating to me. But anyways, yo, finally being able, I think, is that the final page? I think so. Yeah, it is. Bro, finally being able to see so many of these things. Yo, let me take it from the top. This was so awesome. So we got to see Wano, pre-pollution Wano, which by itself looks absolutely amazing. But then after that, we got to see Sudu, yo. Prime Sudu, right next to a bandit, a thief, Kinemon, man. Kinemon was a goat. These dudes were afraid to send individuals to go fight Kinemon because they would not be able to box him. That's how you knew that he was goat.
Kinemon, man.
And you get to see, finally, Sukiyaki. I love this design, like I was saying earlier, man. Sukiyaki's design is so clean. yo, that the way they were hyping, or not hyping up, but explaining how Odin's story up until this point, what he did, like, by each age. Odin is insane, bro. Like, yo, that type of stuff is usually what you would give to, like, a protagonist of your series. And Odin is just a regular, it's just a flashback character. Like, and I feel like, but it makes sense, though, because of how much buildup is behind Odin at this point in time, to have that type of character, that exaggerated form of so many of the different characters from, like, that thing. Because you normally would hear something like that from, I don't know, like, a Yakuza character in, like, movies or something like that, where they exaggerate a lot of this stuff. But in Odin's case, man, yo, this man was out here doing things that other individuals haven't even done in their entire lives. And he was doing it by the time he was six. Like, yo, what a goat. Seeing Prime Hyogoro was awesome. Denjiro. Yo, Denjiro looks a lot like Scarper right here, dog. An orphan from the capital. And I gotta see Lord Odin himself, man. Kozuki Odin, bro. My man has the fresh design with the sideburns. Bro, like I said, dog, this man is out here eating from the pot while it's being cooked. And then to finish off the food, he picks it up with his bare hands and starts just chugging that thing, man. While it's boiling hot. Odin's a boss, dude. He's a boss. Hide your wives. And this one last panel right here as he looks up is really, really nice. The side view. Odin's like, yo, I want you to give me that boar. You know, apparently now we're going to have to deal with a real mountain god. What I'm interested, though, because as you can see, things are already being set up to, like, how they're going to meet up. How, like, Denjiro and Kinemon and, like, all these things are going to connect in the future. But what I love so much about this flashback so far is that you can tell that Oda is going to take his time with it. And that's what I was sort of like, I was like, man, I wonder if Oda's going to rush through it. I wonder if he's going to give us little bits and pieces from each era. Nah, son. We are here for the long run. We're getting a full-blown flashback, which is exactly what I need right now, man. Great first chapter of the flashback. It was so great seeing some of these characters back in how they were 41 years ago. And just, honestly, man, finally being able to see Odin and actually being, like, in the moment with Kozuki Odin. Because in the same chapter, we were able to hear Legends of Odin. And actually being able to see him, and the very first thing that he does is eat directly from a pot while it's being cooked, and then picking it with his bare hands and finishing it. And by himself, it makes him a goat to me, dog. And then you get to see his charm, his hockey, like, on set, not present. Oh, man, dude, I can't wait to see how we're going to meet the rest of the characters and how all this is going to connect later on. But flashback greatness. Whew, man, dude, it just makes me realize, like, the deeper we get into this, the deeper it's going to be crazy, because Odin eventually has to meet Toki. And you know what that means, like, we're going to be introduced to Toki and possibly Toki's story as well, coming from all the way back then in the past. And then, of course, you know, with Ashura Doji, and with Kiku, and all of the other wonderful characters that we've been introduced to in this arc, Kanjuro, Raizo, Kawamatsu, and everyone else. Like, I'm looking forward to seeing all of those stories and how they connect together, because we're gonna have to see Orochi's growth and how he made it up to being the shogun, and then, of course, the actual night where everything went down. So, man, dude, I can already tell it's going to be one of those situations where you know it's going to be coming, but you want him to live anyways. That's how much we're going to love Odin, dog. And just with that premise with, like, that concept in mind, I can't wait for this flashback. I can't, dude. So, man, what a great birthday present, both a Stampede last night and now here this awesome chapter. Finally give us an insight into how Wano was, and just seeing more from Odin, bro. I'm so happy, man. But, yo, everybody has an awesome day, man. Great chapter this week. Really, really enjoyed it. Can't wait to see more from Wano back in the day, following the story of Kozuki Odin. Let me know what y'all thought about this week's chapter, and I will see y'all next time, man. Y'all have a blessed one. Have an awesome day. One Piece greatness, man.